also a shepherd by trade. Sent off into the far, far off land, where he came across the fair Rachel tending her father's sheep. He was smitten. Morton rolled the stone from the well and watered her flock for her. Then Jacob kissed Rachel, lifted up his voice and wept with joy. And Laban, Rachel's father, heard of this. He said to Jacob, "Should you serve me for nothing? Tell me, what shall your wages be?" Jacob said, "I will serve you 7 years for your daughter Rachel." So Jacob served 7 years tending Laban's sheep. And they only seemed but a few days for the love he had for her. And Jacob said to Laban, "Give me my wife, for my days are fulfilled." So Laban threw a great wedding feast. But in the dark of the evening, Laban brought his older daughter into Jacob. And behold, in the morning, it was Leah, not Rachel. Jacob was shocked. He said to Laban, "What is this thou hast done unto me? Did I not serve with thee for Rachel? Why then have you beguiled me?"
"Why then have you beguiled me?" "I must admit that never before has such a tale been found in the pages of a royal diary. Here I expect to be lulled to sleep by tedious reports, and instead I am beguiled by a love story. And how ends your tale? This Jacob, he is able to have his bride?" "He's able to have her?"
"Only after serving 7 more years for her, my lord king."
"Believest you such love?"
"Is it not the greatest commandment? No matter what God one serves."
"How do they call you?"
"Esther Susa."
"Susa? No. Nothing good ever comes out of Susa. Look at me." "Come. Come if you wish to see what I do." "The Greeks, they have a god of similar form. His arms will hold a bow, whose arrows, they say, are tipped with love."
"So much as arrows are tipped with poison, my lord."
"Sometimes. It's hard to tell the difference. The symptoms are the same. Perhaps in another time, some other place. You will reach me again.